to permit widening of the highway and maybe, just maybe, a railway line. Well, the final meeting was held recently, and following time trials, serious racing commenced at dusk. Some very fast passes were run with cars pulling 11 seconds and bikes into the 9 seconds. Highlight of the evening was spectacular burnouts by Ron Laycock on his V8 drag bike, and Steve Hostler's anticipation altered ran hard until it put a foot out of bed, which of course is a Conrad through the block. Very shortly we'll be talking to Clint Elder, who also did very well on his fabulous Honda down there, and we're going to have a look at some of the action from that particular night. Here's the caller that did it for us very well in Brian Muller, and have a look at this for action.
Rod and Custom Club's final drag meeting at the 33 mile Livingston drag strip. Up the line at the moment we have Donald Bayliss, car number 8, 302 Ford XW Ute, coming against his brother Spooty Bayliss in a 302 Ford XY Ute. Both cars warmed up, ready to roll. Donald Bayliss versus Spooty Bayliss. Donald Bayliss lane 1, Spooty Bayliss lane 2. Bayliss taking Spooty Bayliss at the top end. Both cars 302 Ford Utes. Up at the line now we have Barry Weber and Michael Pepper. Barry's a couple of titles. Barry Weber in the 308 Holden leaving Michael Pepper in the 351 Falcon for dead. Up at the line we have Mad on his 307 Chevy drag bike. Smoking up the tyres and falling down the strip. Cubic inches of Chevy V8 power. Up at the line now we have Mostyn Richards and Glenn Bailey. Two XW Falcon sedans, Mostyn Richards coming out of the line well in front of Glenn Bailey in the XW GT. John Ritchie and Neil Hodge, both Taranas, 186, 1202. Up to the line, ready to start. Lights going down. They're off, so 186 leaves the line quicker. In the 186 Tirana beating the 202 Tirana. Brad Perry and David White, two Suzukis, 1750, 1100. Brad Perry lifting the wheel. Inches of Chevy V8 power. Car signalling. Both cars ready to roll. The lights are going down. Michael's Motors, no trouble against the 307 cubic inch HQ Monaro. Michael Pepper and Mostyn Richards. Mostyn in the 351, Michael Pepper in the 302. Very even race down the bottom end. Looks like the 351 and Mostyn Richards might just take him.
Well, with us to talk about drag racing as previous past president of the King Cobra Rod and Custom Club in Clint Elder. Clint, I suppose you're a little disappointed to see the strip closed down, but as you said, the conditions there weren't the best in the world, were they?
No, well, as you could see, Cole, by the film we just had on, the conditions are pretty poor.
Now, some of the vehicles that we saw tonight weren't representative of what generally was expected down there. Bikes, cars, all sorts of cars, I understand.
There's a lot of people sort of holding off for the new strip, which we're hoping for with government assistance.
And where's that going to be, Clint?
That's at the Hidden Valley complex, which is down behind the speedway.
Will this be of a national standard?
Very much so.
Type of conditions that could host a national meeting?
Oh, very much so. We can provide excellent conditions once we have the new track. The last 2 years down south at Winter National have in fact been rained out, and we
have
just don't have that problem, obviously.
What about the problem of getting the vehicles up here? I guess most of them naturally would have to come by road. Do you think that this would be a bit of a deterrent because of the long distance that some of the competitors have to travel?
Well, the Speedway don't seem to have any problem with it, Carl. We believe we can do it. The conditions, the type of place, people can come up for a bit of a holiday and a race too, you know. We all believe it'll work very well. We can continually draw between 600 and 1,000 spectators right down at the 33 mile.
That's a lot of people.
That is, that's a lot of people.
Well, how long will it be before you get underway at the new complex?
Well, that depends really on the government. We've submitted to the government for some money, an estimate of $246,000, which is a lot of money, but we believe that it can be, you know, well and truly worth it from the public's point of view.
Well, just for those of the uninitiated, like myself, let's have a look at some of the types of vehicles. We've seen cars and bikes and the various types of cars and bikes, but I understand that also trucks are part of the
scene. Well, that's right. Basically, Cole, if you can run it on the road or anywhere else, we'll race it for you. We've got a 20, 21...